What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear and today I will show you not how to get beautiful money shots, I will show you why the Lacie 6 pick is actually my main editing rig, and I will explain to you why it is important to choose the right storage device for your needs. So before we get to all the storage madness of the Storage Guy 2018, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also make sure to check the bell in order to be informed when I upload something new. And if you want to check out all the storage benchmarks, also check out my website eddie-bear.com to see the fully written articles about all the stuff I test here. So without further ado, let's start unboxing the Lacie 6 pick. Okay, seriously guys, this is one of the heaviest boxes I ever had on this table. So far, this is 14 kilos of pure storage. So let's jump right in. All right, so this is the Lacie Big 6 with 24 terabytes of pure joy. Trust me when I say this. This little cube here is packing a lot of weight, and this is definitely not something that you want to carry around. The build really feels high quality. This is all metal. Also, the whole front of the Lacie is completely covered in metal. So here you have it where the weight is from.
Now let's take a look at the back of the Lacie 6 BIC. So first we have the power switch, then two Thunderbolt 3 connectors, one USB 3.1 Type-C connector, a Kensington lock, and of course a reset button. As you can see with the connectivity of the Lacie 6 BIC, this is only a direct attached storage, so you will not be able to access it through a network.
Accessing the drives is pretty easy, you just need to pull this side of the bay and then you already can remove the drive. In order to lock the drives again, you just need to push in the drives. They automatically lock into place and you are then good to go. So replacing the drives is pretty easy.
When you remove the drives of the 6 BIC, you will notice that most of the enclosure is made out of aluminum, and this is a big plus since all the other vendors are using plastic parts for their housings. An extra benefit is that all this weight makes this build really sturdy and reduces any unwanted noise.
By the way, even the drives show you that this device is coming with data rescue services. With the Lacie 6 there were also two accessory boxes included, so let's take a look inside what we have here. So we have different power cords for different countries. We receive one USB-C, two USB-C, two USB-C cables, and one USB-A to USB-C cable. Also some paperwork, and in the second box we get even more cables, so you can pretty much operate this device in any country of the world. So, well, I guess they could have saved on the cables a few bucks, but well, it's nice to have them here. The build quality of this storage device is pretty much superior to any other storage device I know of. And if you ever get the chance to lay your hand on one, you will immediately know what I'm talking about. It feels like it's made out of one big aluminum cube. It's pretty much like a MacBook with their unibody design and such, so it feels really professional and it actually is really appealing design-wise. And I have to admit, most of the other storage devices pretty much look like a big blob of plastic on your desk. The build quality is actually not the only thing where the Lacie 6 BIC is scoring big time. When it comes to the whole performance area, as you can see here in the benchmarks, the Lacie has a really good overall score, but the moment you reach the video editing area, it crushes any previous storage device I tested in this guide yet. Naturally, this time I also conducted a photo and video copy test and also an encoding test with our 4K test file. Now let's first take a look on the benchmark results we had from the photocopy and the videocopy tests.
The results of the photocopy test are actually quite interesting since the Drobo 5T3 outperforms the Lacie 6 Big, so this means the Drobo systems are optimized for photo archives. The moment we come to the video files, those values change dramatically, so the Lacie 6 Big obliterates the whole competition by far.
As you can see, the 6 Big is crushing it when it comes to video files or video editing. So if I take Final Cut and throw in 3 or 4 4K video streams, it pretty much has no problem dealing with them, and it makes my life so much easier, I'm telling you, because I don't have to wait for the storage to catch up with my editing. I can edit, maybe I have to pause for a second or what, and then it's already good to go again. So this will help you to get your edits out faster. I know it pretty much punches a big hole in your wallet, but this is money well spent, my friend. Since we are already talking about editing and encoding, the results of the 4K test footage were actually quite surprising. In the previous tests, I tested the Drobo 5T3 and the QNAP TS-453BT3. Man, I still know it! Both these devices performed pretty much the same with the 4K test footage, so both needed somewhere around 17 minutes to perform the whole encoding process, and I was assuming that my bottleneck at this point was my late 2016 MacBook Pro. Well, the Lacie 6 Big actually showed me differently. So actually I was able to lower my encoding time by 2 minutes all the way down to 15 minutes. So you may say, why spend so much money on just 2 minutes? Well, actually the biggest improvement is not in the encoding time, it's actually in the video editing. I save so much time in video editing because I don't have to wait for my whole storage or my computer to catch all the way up to my editing if I re-watch my latest edit or something. I'd even go so far and say that the 6 Big helped me to cut down my editing time maybe by half or even down to 1/3 of the previous time I needed to finish one video editing. Since now all the benchmark values are in, it's time to take a look at the final score of the Lacie 6 Big in my YouTube Storage Guide 2018. So, drum roll, it scored whooping 9,800 points this time. So this means by today it is the highest scoring contestant in the Storage Guide, and now I will tell you why. From a hardware standpoint, the Lacie 6 Big is raising the bar pretty much here. So if you take a look on what comes with this device, one USB-C cable, one Thunderbolt 3 cable, and one USB-C to Type-A USB cable, and also pretty much all the power plugs you can imagine all over the world. So this is really a rich accessory box that Lacie throws in here. Also, all the drives come with their rescue plan, so if one of your drive fails, you have 5 years to send it back to Lacie. They will try to recover the data that is stored on this drive and they will replace it with a new one. This makes the 6 Big almost an enterprise-grade device. Sure, it has not all the redundancies that enterprise devices have, but you get a glimpse of what you can get out of an enterprise-grade storage device. Another thing I had to try out, since I love to play around with all the toys I have, I wanted to know whether it is possible to upgrade the Lacie 6 Big by yourself. So this means you can take out all the drives in there, replace them with your own, and you actually can upgrade the capacity in the 6 Big with this pretty simple step. But let's face it, replacing 6 drives with this amount of capacity is quite expensive, so maybe it could be even cheaper to get a new device, but I guess it pretty much depends on how the rates are at the moment. Another thing that really surprised me while I was working with the Lacie 6 Big is actually the noise level. So, in my previous reviews, I tested the Drobo 5D3 and the QNAP TS-453BT3, and those devices were kinda okay to use in an office environment, but since they were so loud, I have the impression that those devices actually could get annoying in certain office environments. Sure, the QNAP was way quieter than the Drobo was, but still, the 6BIG sets the bar on this one. I measured a noise level of 37 decibels. So this is just 5 decibels louder than the Lacie 4TB external hard drive I tested in the beginning. So this means the 6 drives that are rotating behind me are as loud as 1 external hard drive. This actually makes the 6BIG not only an accessory you want to place on your desk cause it's looking good, you also want to place it there cause you can and it will not annoy you by all the, you know, heads moving around and making annoying noises. Sure, you can hear when the array is spinning up and whatnot, but while you're editing, it's actually quite fine. So definitely a big plus for the 6BIG. So what is my overall verdict on the Lacie 6BIG? Well, it without a doubt will rip a big hole in your wallet, but aside the price, I have a hard time finding any negative point on this package here. From design to performance to ease of use to handling, this device pretty much leaves no wish unfulfilled. Maybe one thing could be there. If this device would be accessible by a network connection, this would complete the whole package, but Lacie is known for direct attached devices and not for network attached systems. So I guess let's leave the whole network thing for QNAP. And if you want something that is easy to use and delivers fast performance, go for a Lacie device and you will have tons of fun with it. So with that said, hit me up in the comments and tell me what you think about the Lacie 6BIG. So is this a device you would consider for yourself? Or is this something you would avoid sheerly off the big price tag it comes with? Hit me up and tell me what you think. Also let me know what devices are you using for your video or image editing. And who knows, maybe I will include it in one of my future storage guide episodes. So with that said, thank you for watching and I see you in the next one.